Greatest highlight would definitely be top of Mount Warning, like climbing up in the dark to get to the top, just climbing, not knowing where you're going, and then eventually, but getting to the top and seeing the sunrise, that was amazing. That was definitely a highlight.
Dawn climb up the peak to Mount Warning. I think that was one of the beautiful sights that I've had so far for this journey of Albon, Australia. Beautiful things to see how the sunrise over the other hills. Okay, where you get to see the city of the lakes. The town is beautiful.
Yep. It would have been just sitting in the water, like near the waterfall at what's it called, Minion Falls. Mm. That was pretty awesome. I love just sitting there and hearing the water crash and the wind and all that.
Waterfall, that was extraordinary to be from the top of 90 meter waterfall and then down to the bottom where I had a freezing cold dip, which was very nice.
Probably be in the campsites that we go to every night, and like all the stars come up and the food that we get to eat, and having to sit around with people and just chit chatting with them.
My greatest highlight will be the nights at the campsite. I think every night is a great memory, and whenever it comes to food, it's always a surprise, because even if we know the ingredients, we won't know how it will turn out to be. And definitely the campfires, which created this very nice environment in the cold for us to just catch up on each other instead of going back to our tents.
My biggest highlight for this course itself is mountain biking. Especially going down the hills. In Singapore, we won't have that much opportunity to do that. It just pumped my adrenaline.
Yeah.
I think that was the most exciting part of this course.
Cycle up and down the slope is really very fun. And it's a hard push up the slope, and but when the downhill you get rewarded by the slope, oh, and God, the adrenaline. It's like really really fun. I really enjoyed it.
Oh yeah, mountain biking going down slope. That was scary. My shot. Okay.
Now has got to be our bike expedition leg, where there are plenty of up slopes. I think that really burned all the thighs and calves. But seeing LG and seeing Ibrahim, I think it made me realize how tough life could be, but it's just a matter of how much I want.
My highlights would be to be able to go through this with a group of people that I really love. And it reminds me of Staff X, which I have missed for the past 3 years. So this is highlights!
Whitewater canoeing. Because one thing is, I like water pretty much. And other than that, I haven't canoed before, not to mention on whitewater. So it was rather an interesting experience, I would say. And at the same time, being on a canoe with a single paddle, or rather a single-sided paddle, I really have to rely on my buddy to manage the other side of the canoe.
My greatest challenge, probably the emotion part when it comes to canoeing, because you know, we are so used to control our own kayaks, and now we're forced to partner up with someone, and with the loaded kayak and the longer boat, definitely the maneuverability will be limited. It just creates this frustration when it comes to going down the river. It just makes it very challenging.
Song for the broken hearted. A silent prayer for faith departed. I ain't gonna be just a face in the crowd. You're gonna hear my voice when I shout it out loud. It's my
I just wanna live it.
Okay, so what were some of the challenging moments for you over there?
There were a few physical moments, challenging moments. So a couple of them were during when I was trekking, carrying a heavy load as I was walking through the national park. And of course, other challenging, physical challenging moment was when I was cycling, especially uphill. The other part that I think I managed well, except certain instances, was the managing the cold. So there were a few times when I was still wet and I was on the canoe, and the wind just catch you unaware. You just send a chill down your spine. There's something that I thought was a more like psychological or mental barrier, and that was most of the, of course, the fellow participants were from my or are from my workplace. So I was a bit afraid that they may have some workplace impression on me, and that may not allow us to connect to each other better. But I believe it was well managed throughout the whole program.
I see.
Mm. Greatest challenge probably be the cold.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's hard to do anything when it's cold. Yeah. Fingers are frozen, you don't feel like doing anything. You don't feel like going up. Yeah, I think that was my biggest challenge.
Okay. Challenge?
I think the weather, to adapt to the weather, is extremely cold for me.
Mm.
The greatest challenge is the lack of sleep. I couldn't sleep very well every night.
3 days of hiking, especially the 20-kilometer hike. The day after when we hiked down to the waterfall was all fun and games, but then once the hike to the bus came, my legs were just absolutely burning, so that was quite a challenge to push through that.
Challenge is my physical fitness law. The extra 10 kilos that I put on after pregnancy is an additional load on my shoulders.
The biggest challenge would be doing solo itself, being away from my family. As you know, it's a festive season, it's a Hari Raya, it's a challenge to me. The eve of Hari Raya, and we are alone.
The greatest challenge is for me to be myself. I think there was this one short moment when I was at the service learning that I kind of let loose and sang the Armageddon song. I think that was that moment in time where it was me being me. Yeah.
I think it's got to be Scout, our land expedition mascot. I think it really represents a lot about an outbounder. How much you should never stop exploring the environment, never stop exploring yourself. Always willing to give and be there for others as a service.
Yep. Scout, our favorite dog that came with us.
Greatest inspiration would be just how everyone works together and how we're such a good team. That's definitely a takeaway for anywhere you go in work or business when you work with other groups.
The inspiration would be to dedicate more time for myself, because after I've been a mother, my life has been about 一节. I stopped doing a lot of stuff that I like. Even going to KTV with my brothers takes a scheduling 3 months down the road. So I think I need to devote more time for myself, love myself more, get fitter so that I can love others better.
It's about getting to know my colleagues better, and knowing that once you put away personal interests, departmental interests, everyone is generally very caring and concerned and very supportive of whatever we do.
Okay.
So it's something I want to bring back to work. Second part will be real inspiration from our river guide, who is actually very old and very matured. So regardless of his age, he's still very passionate and has great knowledge in his area of specialty. So it just caught me that if I'm really interested in this field or future field, I should really strive and be good at it and continue to work in it until the day my body can't take it.
Just takeaways. I think one of the most inspiring things is just seeing people around me push on even when they are tired, struggling up the hill on a bike, or just pushing up with their backpacks, but they don't stop. So I think it's a reminder for me to just keep pushing as well. I'm so nervous!